In this video, we will discuss best solutions for handling Network 1 errors in NeoLoad. By the end of this video, you will know the best approach to take when encountering this type of error. Let's begin. You may come across Network 1 errors when validating your tests in NeoLoad. In this video, we will be answering two questions: why this error happens, and how you are able to fix it. To better understand how to fix this type of error, let's take a minute to understand why it occurs. Network 1 errors typically occur when your server fails to respond with the expected results that NeoLoad awaits. When this occurs, you will typically see two types of Network 1 errors. The first being a java.net no route to host exception error, and the second being a java.net socket exception error. The no route to host exception error indicates that an error occurred while attempting to connect a socket to a remote address and port. This typically happens because of an intervening firewall or an intermediate router is down. The socket exception error indicates that your target server or network device had become overloaded. Now that we have explored two types of Network 1 errors and possible causes, we will demonstrate four possible solutions that can reduce the likelihood of this error occurring. The first solution is geared towards Network 1 socket exception errors. For Network 1 socket exception errors, you can increase the number of load generators for your test. Your test could be exceeding the total number of requests that are possible on a given load generator. Increasing to more load generators will spread the load out more evenly. You can add more load generators by going to the NeoLoad controller interface. Select Runtime. Select the plus sign in the upper right-hand corner. In the List of Load Generators section, give the IP address of the load generator to be added and click OK. Once you have successfully added the load generator, it will show under the default zone. And that's it. You've increased your load generators. Our next solution is another way to check for overloading. For solution two, you can run your test using fewer virtual users. This is generally a good practice if you want to identify if your servers are overloaded. To run your test using fewer virtual users, you will select the Runtime button from the NeoLoad controller interface. In the Initial Users Number section, you will decrease your virtual users. And that's it. You are done. NeoLoad will run the next tests using fewer virtual users. For Network 1 no route to host exception errors, you can try Solution 3. Solution 3 is to disable your computer's antivirus or firewall. You may need to check with your company's IT department before doing this. Disabling your antivirus or firewall and then running your test helps to isolate whether your firewall or antivirus are blocking the web traffic. There are also a few settings in NeoLoad you can adjust to contain Network 1 errors, which brings us to our fourth and final solution. Uncheck the option for using HTTP2. HTTP2 is a newer protocol focused on performance, specifically end user perceived latency, network, and server resource usage. However, not all applications use HTTP2 protocol. By disabling HTTP2, you are telling NeoLoad to only use the universally supported HTTP1 protocol when running your tests. This should eliminate Network 1 errors if the application you are testing does not support the HTTP2 protocol. You can uncheck the option for using HTTP2 by going to the main NeoLoad controller interface. Select the Design button, select the Populations tab, select the three dots called the picker in the section labeled Browser. A browser profile picker window will open, and you will see the HTTP2 box listed in the right. Uncheck the box if it is checked. Select OK, and you are done. This concludes our video on NeoLoad Network One errors and best solutions. We answered why Network One errors occur and how you are able to solve them.